first concerts of the saxophone camp. I have to tell you that this is a real bittersweet moment for all of us. Usually, this first concert is just fun and joyous. It's a chance for us to see old friends, old students, and just celebrate the saxophone and music. And this year, we have a couple of conspicuous absences. And the first of those is Dr. Thomas Liley. Now, Tom was a faculty member here for, I believe, over 10 years, and was just really integral to everything that went on during the camp. And he passed away really tragically this past January. And he's left a big hole in all of our hearts. I met Tom 35 years ago. He was the first person I met when I was a freshman at Indiana University. And I was preening under my ears, and Tom took me inside, and he showed me the way to go through the world. And he has been one of my best and dearest friends since that day. And as it turns out, almost everyone you talk to will say the same thing. He was their best friend, he was their best supporter, and everyone felt wonderful about it. And not only us, Tom was integral to the North American Saxophone Alliance, the World Saxophone Congress. There isn't a saxophonist playing professionally today that doesn't have Tom. And so we all miss him. Great. So tonight's concert is to honor and celebrate Tom's life in the best way we know him, and that's to make music.
Thank you.
like to invite Dr. Eric Nusser to come up, and he has a couple of words he'd like to say on behalf of Dr. Eugene Rousseau, who couldn't be here tonight. Eric is a saxophone professor at North Texas State University in Denton, Texas. This is his first time as a faculty member up here, and we're super pleased to have him. And please welcome him.
What a terrific job, Steve. My God, that sounds fabulous. Didn't it sound fabulous? Yeah. So, as you know, Dr. Rousseau is not here with us today, but he has sent me as his emissary to share a few words that he has asked me to speak on behalf of Thomas Liley, which I will do just now. And as I speak, we prepared a booklet, and we hope to send a recording of tonight's concert and this booklet to his wife, Nancy Liley. So, if you would, be so kind as to take one of the pens in this booklet and sign your name. And if you wish to include a short little message to Nancy Liley, I think she would appreciate that. This is from Dr. Rousseau. It was at the Midwestern Art Camp in Lawrence, Kansas, University of Kansas, that I first met Thomas Liley. That was more than 40 years ago. He was a student at KU and a valuable assistant to the then director of this renowned camp, Russell Liley. I observed that Tom was so careful in his attention to detail, so proactive, that he could have assumed Dr. Wiley's job. My responsibilities at this camp included presenting a recital and giving lessons to the high school students who were enrolled. One day, Tom asked if he could have a lesson, and that was the beginning of a long relationship. We stayed in touch. And several years later, I had the opportunity to hear Tom play a recital at a saxophone convention in Missouri. Not only did he demonstrate his musical ability, but he also conveyed a sense of purpose and a thirst for knowledge. Some months later, he enrolled at Indiana University for graduate study. He was an outstanding student and earned a Doctor of Music degree with distinction. It was customary for my wife, Norma, to prepare dinner at least once each year for my students. As she became acquainted with each of the members of this talented group, she often remarked that Tom was very bright but soft-spoken, that he possessed a keen intellectual curiosity, and that he was always unassuming and thoughtful. Through the years, Tom became a good friend of ours. His performance career had many high points, including being a member of the U.S. Navy Band and giving performances throughout the world. His trips to China as a visiting artist teacher were memorable, both for him and for the Chinese students and teachers he met. He never put his saxophone on the shelf, except when he had finished practicing for the day. He knew full well what my teacher, Marcel Mule, often said, "One never arrives." He was undoubtedly the world's best-known scholar for matters related to the saxophone and has numerous publications to his credit. He most recently provided me with valuable information regarding the history of our instrument. As a teacher, he was open-minded, clear in his presentations, valued, and admired. Although he never verbalized this to me, his life as a teacher was as Alfred Einstein once described himself: "I never teach my pupils. I only attempt to provide the conditions in which they can learn." Tom and I, often Tom, Norma, and I, met several times each and every year at the Midwest International Band Clinic in Chicago, at the yearly International Masterclass event in Minneapolis, the Shell Lake Saxophone Workshop, and at all major saxophone conventions, most recently the World Saxophone Congress last July in Scotland. in 1969, when Paul Brody and I established the World Saxophone Congress, Tom was a charter member. And during the World Saxophone Congress 13 in Minneapolis, 2003, he worked diligently as a key member of the organizing committee. He was an exceptional colleague and would walk 2 miles to get someone else to walk one. It is a privilege to share this time with you in celebration of the wonderful life of a wonderful human being. Thomas Liley, excellent musician, outstanding teacher, brilliant scholar, cherished colleague, and dear friend. Simon, you give him so. But my friend too. Dr. Rousseau also wishes to send his greetings to you. So, greetings to all. With a special welcome to those who participate in the Saxophone Workshop 2013. The first saxophone workshop occurred more than 40 years ago. There were 9 students enrolled. Since then, there have been hundreds of participants, and I believe it is fair to say that this event has been a positive experience for those who have been in attendance. Some students have continued their study of the saxophone and today are prominent in their profession, like Clark Crandall and Steven Stusek. Others look back upon their experience at Shell Lake knowing that their lives have been enriched because of it. Were it not for the vision, hard work, and dedication of Darryl and Billy Aderman, the Shell Lake Arts Center would not exist. Being a part of this environment where learning generates excitement has been both a pleasure and a privilege for me and for my wife. And we have felt this way every year since its inception. It is difficult for me to envision the 2013 saxophone workshop without my participation, but that is the reality. I know that this year's workshop will be highly successful because I know the faculty very well. I should, as they are all former students of mine, and I'm very proud of them. I look forward to returning for the 2014 saxophone workshop. And as I think of next year and beyond, a future participant comes immediately to mind. Alec Rousseau, age 10, at present in Mexico City, who just completed his first study book. And I think everyone has already seen him because you walked through the door and saw that wonderful photo. And I would also like you to turn your attention this way to the atrium. Thank you.
Saxophone, and then you say, ah, I know. So let's do a warm welcome for Art Crandall.
Thank you.
the style of Brahms. The whole piece is four movements. It's about 25 minutes long. It's for violin, alto saxophone, and piano. And we did an arrangement for the first movement, and I'll be playing the violin part on soprano saxophone. And I'm really glad. The piece was just finished recently, 2012. Tom had a chance to play it and premiere it at the World Saxophone Congress in Scotland last summer. And then he played it just a week before his death at the Navy Saxophone Symposium in Washington, D.C. I was at that performance. And I have to say, Tom gave the most lovely performance I've ever heard of yet. And so that was a great privilege. So I hope you enjoyed. This is just the first movement.
Thank you.
Selvig Art Center Saxophone Quartet. Two short pieces for you. The first is a real bronze piece, part of a choral symphony. And Thomas had once mentioned to his wife that if he ever died, he would love to have it play at his funeral. And as it happens, David Canfield, the composer of this last piece, was a close friend of Tom's, and he jumped right in and in one afternoon arranged this piece. And then a quartet in Iowa learned the music, and they had one day to learn it, and they came and played it, and it was very special. So anyway, let's bring on the quartet, and we'll play for you, quartet. Here we are, we've got the fourth member, showing the SLAC Art Center faculty saxophone stage.
Thank you. really elegant, well-composed literature from the 19th century, especially Notre Dame in France. So this is a quartet, an allegro de concert, typical of this period, composed in 1879.
Thank you.
on the occasion of Dr. Rousseau's 76th birthday. So it's funny, we hosted his birthday celebration at my school in North Carolina. And the problem was, wherever the saxophonist went, Norman Rousseau went too. And the thing was, we wanted this piece to be a surprise for him. Just playing in her honor. And it's like we were trying to rehearse it, and we're in the room, and there's Norman. And I said to Thomas, can you think of anything that we can play this piece without her knowing about it? And Thomas said, I know just what to do. And he went and he said, Norma, I have to talk to you about something really important. We can't do it here. And he got her out of the room and we practiced this piece, and then we played it. And so we're playing it again tonight because it meant a lot for Tom, and a lot for Dr. Rousseau. Especially about the saxophone. Just don't ask Preston anymore.